Welcome to this brief guide on how to use document tabs in Google Docs. Have you ever felt lost in a sea of pages in your Google Docs? Frustrated with scrolling endlessly to find that one section that you need? Or maybe you're tired of juggling multiple documents for different parts of a project? Well, say goodbye to those document dilemmas. Google Docs tabs are here to save the day, and in this tutorial, I'll show you exactly how to use them like a pro. We'll cover creating tabs, organizing them with subtabs, navigating efficiently, and even some cool tricks to streamline your workflow. Get ready to become a tab master. All right, let's dive right into creating tabs. Tabs are essentially like dividers in a binder. They let you separate your document into distinct sections. This is incredibly helpful for keeping things organized, especially when you're working with longer documents. No more endless scrolling. First things first, we need to open the Tabs panel. See that icon in the top left corner that says Show Tabs and Outlines? Go ahead and click on that. This opens up a handy side panel where you'll manage all of your tabs. You'll see that your first tab is made automatically for you. Let's double-click on that tab and give this tab a clear, descriptive name. Let's say we're working on a report all about renewable energy. I might name this first tab Introduction, just like that. Now notice that plus sign at the top of the panel? That's your Add a Tab button. Click on it and boom, a brand new tab appears in your document. Let's name this one Solar Power. And let's add a couple more tabs for the different sections of our report. We'll add one for Wind Energy and then one more for Hydroelectric Power. Perfect. See how easy that was? Now, whenever I click on a tab in this side panel, the main document area will change to show me the content within that specific section. So if I want to jump to the wind energy section, I can just click on that tab and there it is. No more scrolling through pages and pages to find what I need. Okay, so we've got our main sections set up with tabs. But what if we want to organize those sections even further? That's where subtabs come in. They allow you to create subsections within your main tabs, adding in another layer of organization. To create a subtab, simply left-click on the ellipsis menu at the end of one of your main tabs. Let's try it with the Solar Power tab. When you click, you'll see an option that says Add Subtab. Go ahead and click that. Now we can give our subtab a name. Since this is under the Solar Power section, let's create a subtab called Benefits to discuss the advantages of solar energy. And let's add another one called Challenges to explore some of the potential drawbacks. Now notice how our Solar Power tab has these two subtabs nested underneath it. If I click on Solar Power, I see the general content for that section. But if I click on the Benefits subtab, it will take me directly to the information about the advantages of solar power. This is a fantastic way to break down complex topics into smaller, more digestible chunks. Let's try it with another tab. I'll click on the Wind Energy tab and add a subtab for onshore wind and another for offshore wind. See? Building this structure with tabs and subtabs can make your document super easy to navigate. And now that we have all of these tabs and subtabs, how do we actually use them to move around our document? Well, the most straightforward way is to simply click on a tab in the side panel. But there are a couple of other handy tricks that you should know. For those of you who love keyboard shortcuts, like I do, there's a way that you can do this with your keyboard. On Windows, just press Ctrl+Shift+Page+ to go to the previous tab, or Ctrl+Shift+Page+ to go to the next tab. It's that easy. And for those of you on Mac OS, simply use Command-Shift-Page-Up or Page-Down instead. This is a quick way to move through your document section by section. Imagine trying to find a specific piece of information in a 100-page document without tabs. You'd be scrolling forever. But with tabs, you can instantly jump to the hydroelectric power section, and then you're right where you need to be. It's a huge time saver. All right, now let's take a look at how we can customize these tabs. Left-click on the ellipsis menu at the end of any tab to open up the tab options menu. There are a few useful things that you can do here. First, you can duplicate a tab. This is handy if you need to create a section that's similar to an existing one. Let's say we want to add a section on geothermal energy. Instead of creating a whole new tab from scratch, I can simply click on the solar power tab, select duplicate tab, and then rename it to geothermal energy. It will copy across all of the formatting for you, which can potentially save you a lot of time. Next, you can delete a tab if you no longer need it. Maybe we decided to remove the hydroelectric power section from our report. I can simply select that tab and select delete tab. Just like that, it's gone. You can even elect to move tabs into others using the move into option. When you do so, it will become a sub-tab of whichever tab you choose to move it into. The best part here is that any existing sub-tabs will also come along for the ride. And finally, you can even add an emoji to your tabs. This is a great way to visually organize your document. For example, I might make all the tabs related to renewable energy sources use the sun emoji, and any tabs I create related to fossil fuels can use a dinosaur one. It helps you quickly identify the different sections at a glance. To change the emoji for a tab, just left-click on the ellipsis, select Choose Emoji, and then choose the one you want. You can even use the search box to more readily find the one you need. And one of the coolest things about tabs is how they work with Google Docs' built-in outline feature. The outline gives you a structured overview of your entire document, making it easy to see the hierarchy of your content. Whenever you create a heading in your document, like a title or a subtitle, it automatically appears in the outline panel. So if I type in benefits of solar power as a heading in my document, it shows up right here in the outline under the benefits subtab. You can use the outline to quickly jump to different sections of your document. Just simply click on a heading in the outline and it will take you right to that spot. You can also collapse and expand sections in the outline. So if I want to focus on the challenges of solar power, I can collapse the other sections to hide those details. This allows me to easily focus on the specific parts of my outline and navigate my document with precision. So as you can see, tabs and outlines work together beautifully to create a truly organized and navigable document. This is especially helpful for collaborative projects where multiple people are working on the same document. Everyone can easily see the structure and find the information they need. Congratulations! You've now covered everything from creating basic tabs to mastering subtabs, navigation tricks, customization options, and how tabs integrate with the outline feature. You are well on your way to becoming a Google Docs tab expert. And remember, you can access Google Docs from any web browser. Just head over to docs.google.com to start organizing your documents like a pro today, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.